We're live. I clapped.
Did you fucking clap?
All right. So we put up a video about a year ago now, right?
Something like that.
Working on running mechanics, and VJ was up on the treadmill, did an amazing job, and just got a tremendous amount of people interested in the video. And the hiccup was we never really intended it to be a tutorial of any net worth. And people kept asking, where's the other half? Where's the rest of it?
Yeah, so we started that video as kind of like a part one. All right, we're gonna start from the bottom, work our way up. The very first drills, things you need to do, working on mechanics, getting into moving appropriately. Start there.
And some amazing tips.
Amazing tips coming from the man himself.
We're gonna do some things that are way outside the box that we've been using here in the lab forever that really, really makes a huge, huge difference. And I promise you, I'm gonna finish this up with a tip that you just wanna make sure you wait for. Cool?
Sounds good.
Well, ahead of where we've been in the past, but what you're seeing right now is, if you're paying attention, his foot is remaining beneath his knee. His initial contact is on the forefoot, but he's allowing his heel to settle to the deck. And we are at, what speed is that?
6 miles an hour, 10-minute mile.
So we're at 6 miles per hour, which is a 10-minute mile. And that's very, very, very manageable. And I would recommend for those that are trying to transition onto their forefoot, that they don't fast forward and try to get into race pace or try to use a pace that they normally might run if they were on their heels. Because you need to learn to find the ground. And I've said this a million times to my clients, the most important thing to consider is where your foot makes contact with the ground. Don't worry about what happens behind you. Don't worry about trying to get your heel up towards your butt. Just make sure that you make contact forefoot to heel and allow the foot to land beneath the knee. Now we're going to do this with the metronome set at 180 strides per minute. And then this is where this gets to be more interesting. Regardless of the speed of the belt, we're going to stay at the same frequency. Let's do it. Okay, so here we are, 6 miles per hour, 10-minute pace, and you can see that there is virtually no overstriding going on. Contact point is good. Now, for those of you that are learning to make this transition, it's critical that you own this before you decide to move into greater speed. And so, because he's very capable of doing this, we're going to fast forward. Let's bring it to 8 miles per hour for me. Now, something that most people won't tell you when they're teaching you how to do this on a treadmill is that because the belt is moving regardless of what you do, you need to make some modifications to the way you move to complement your gait on the belt. This is referred to as rate independent running. Because the belt's moving, you're just keeping up with it. The belt's moving independent of your function. If you were outside, it would be rate dependent, which means it requires that what you do off the ground is what's going to propel you. Now, you might notice very little difference in the gait pattern, even though we're 2 miles per hour faster than we were a moment ago. If you're really keen and paying attention, you'll start to notice that the stride is opening up behind you. Let's bring it up to 10. So we're going to move to a 6 minute mile pace. And I want you to notice that now the stride is opening up behind him, but his ground contact is the same. It's right on point. And so the important thing to take home from this is that regardless of the speed he's creating, variation in his cadence. And as it turns out, being at this stride frequency is most likely the most efficient way to provide force off the ground. And so you're starting to notice his hip angles opening up a little bit. And things are going very, very nicely. Alright, so we spoke earlier about the rate independence that's his atrium running on a bell. And so what I need him to do is I need him to draw his knees up a little bit, and that will help to cure the reaching that he's doing. We're at a 6-minute mile pace. So what else I want you to consider is that at the waist, he's neutral. No rotation here because there's no rotation here. You want to keep the shoulders quiet. Arm swing is good. We want to draw the lightly cupped fist back to the hip and just above or right at about the chest. And just a nice comfortable pace. This is what it should look like. Now, the problem with most novice athletes that have a little bit of physical talent is that they think, well, I can run faster than that. So what ends up happening is the legs start to encroach further up into a braking stance. If that lower leg starts to dip into a forward angle like this, then what we're doing is we're imposing a brake. And this is not good. It also encourages more vertical oscillation. So now you're bouncing and stabbing the ground, which is definitely what you don't want to do.
Okay, so what you may notice here is that we've got this belt which is fixed to the front of my treadmill on a rather large rubber band. And it is connected to his waist so that there's a kinesthetic awareness. As you can see, he's getting a little bit of a forward lean, which is something you're incapable of doing on a treadmill minus this device. And it also helps to encourage a more inline posture from the ankles to the head and promotes the drive of the knee. And so this is a great way to entrain your ability to drive with your knees and make sure that your ground contact is precise. We do this quite a lot. It's a little taxing, a little bit more taxing than it might be if you were just to be running on the treadmill. Let's hit that cadence. Okay, so I'm going to start from the bottom. And as you can see, I'm going to get a little bit of a lean into that belt. And look how well he's able to keep his feet beneath his knees as he's running. Everything's working out very nicely here. I understand that most people will not have a belt that travels in both directions on their treadmills. However, if you're creative enough, you can rig this up from behind, maybe put a screw into the wall and attach an eye bolt to it. And I mean, it depends on where you are, or maybe even have your friend hold on to the belt for you. But the focus is not to see how hard you can pull against the belt. It's more a function of getting this kinesthetic awareness. Really cool stuff. Okay, so we're still on the belt facing backwards. We're still harnessed. Go ahead and get in. And so try to feature that perception is key to all of this. Sometimes you feel like you're doing it right where in fact you're not. And because he's harnessed, there's some advantages in the way he's moving. And you can see if I pan down that his contact point looks good. But the tip I promised you, as you see this device here, I've got a stand you could purchase on Amazon that is holding my iPad for like a presentation. And what he's doing with this auxiliary camera that I have on the other side of the deck is we're actually allowing him to watch how he's running from the side in real time. There's nothing more powerful than altering your perception to learn to run properly. And this, my friends, is such a cool tool. If I just leave him alone in here, he can watch how he's doing, he can make corrections, he knows what it is he's trying to accomplish, but this is allowing him to see whether in fact he's doing it right or whether he's doing it wrong.
What we're gonna do, see little finger? We are going to hop on one foot. Now this obviously is a very low rate of speed, but I promise you, you are not likely to screw this up. If you find that you're tripping over yourself, you can't find balance, it's because your nature is you tend to overstride. But if you keep at it for these low rates of speed, you're going to start landing on the treadmill more effectively. And then what you want to do is shorten up the time on each foot. Let's go to like 3 or 4 on each foot. And let's go to 2. And then just alternate. Just run. Bingo. He tricked himself into landing on his forefoot properly. Notice his heels touching down very lightly. So he's not reaching, he's not toe diving. Works out very, very nicely.